Hello, good morning, this is Rob Koster for CardGameExpert.com and today I will be playing some Vintage Humans. This was a deck request by one of the viewers. And as always, if you want me to play your deck, you just let me know through the comments, you can message me, it's all fine. As long as you reach me, I'll consider playing your deck. Anyway, this is a Vintage Humans deck. This is a lot like the Modern Humans deck. We have Noble Hierarch, we have Champion of the Parish, we have Thalia's Lieutenant, we have Thalia. We have Mayor of Avabrook, we have Dark Confident, we have Kambal, we have General Kudrow, we have Thalia Heretic Cartel, which doesn't really see play in the modern fit, but is more than legal. So yeah, we have some vintage level cards, we have the usual pile of fast mana cards, we have a Black Lotus, we have a Lotus Petal, Mana Crypt, Mox Emerald, Mox Jet, Mox Pearl. These are all just power 9, probably everybody knows these, but just mentioning them, I'm playing them. With that being said, things that you don't see in the modern version of this is Once Upon a Time. Yeah, well, if it was legal, we would definitely play it there. And we have Sanctum Prelate. This is just a card that, when it enters the battlefield, choose a number. No creature spells with converted mana cost equal to the chosen number can be cast. So this is basically just a very powerful Chalice of the Void type effect. That if Chalice of the Void was reprinted these days, this is how they would word it. And we have Palace Jailer, which draws cards when you're attacking. For the rest, the mana base also very similar to the modern one. We have Unclaimed Territory, we have Silent Clearing, we have Nurturing Peatland, we have Mana Confluence, we have Horizon Canopy and Cavern of Souls. Things we do have now is access to Wasteland and Strip Mine. Strip Mine obviously just a better one, but restricted. We have 4 Wasteland in here. And for the rest, we have 1 Karakas to bounce stuff like a Grizzlebrand or something. Save our Thalia from Bolt, like stuff like that. You can do some fun stuff with this, and it's basically a free roll here. With that being said, the sideboard is a bunch of Containment Priests, also very playable in the modern version. We have Source to Plowshares here instead of like Bolt or something. We have 4 Surgical Extraction, Dredge is very much a deck around here. We have Force of Vigor, which we can also play in the modern version, and Collector Oof, which we also play in the modern version. So this version is really close to the modern version, and the Power 9 really isn't that expensive. Like if you have, I think like a 50 or 100 bucks, you can play Vintage Humans when you own the modern deck. It's like very cheap. I was actually really surprised by how little it changed. So with that being said, as always, this video is being sponsored by Mana Traders. Check out the link in the description below for a discount on your first 3 months. And with that being said, let's get to the games. Okay, so for our first match, we have a Mox Jet, Champion of the Parish, Thalia. They open up on the Preordain. We have double combo, which seems really good here. We play the Mox Jet, we play Thalia on turn 1, which seems good in a Preordain format, just putting it out there. And they end up Force of Willing it. They play a second Preordain. They think about it, they Brain Freeze themselves here. So Brain Freeze is target player mills 3 cards with Storm. So they mill over an Underworld Breach, which is really scary. I play a Noble Hierarch, they play a Time Walk. So Time Walk not that interesting here, just another turn for them, just doesn't add that much. Like they ponder, they're definitely looking for answers here to the humans. They're on 1 card in hand. So they play a Lotus Petal. So they have 1 card. I play a Sanctum Prelate and I just don't know the format well enough, so I end up putting it on 2 here. And yeah, that's just wrong. Like I should have put, looking at that graveyard, I should have put it on 3, because now they Savinny's Reclamation me, which is a card I had never seen before in my life. And they end up getting back the Underworld Breach. So yeah, that enters the battlefield and a Narset from them milling themselves. And now they can just mill themselves out. They Lightning Bolt the Sanctum Prelate. So yeah, they have 1 card in hand. They might have milled over the Savinny's. I hadn't seen it. So yeah, things happen. Now they're just playing a bunch of Lotus Petals from the graveyard, just brainstorming themselves, intuition, just getting more cards in the graveyard. Like Underworld Breach is a stupid card in every format. I don't like that card at all. I hate that it's been printed. I wish we could shift delete that one from existence. So yeah, now they just mill themselves some more. They just mill over their entire deck. So yeah, now they can just keep playing the Black Lotus. Play Black Lotus again, play Black Lotus again, play Black Lotus again. And now they Brain Freeze and now they just have enough to mill me out. So in response to them milling me, I just concede. I end up taking out 4 Mayor of Everbrook. I just think that too slow here, and I bought it in 4 Surgical. So I have Once Upon a Time, Kambal, Thalia, Nurturing Peatland Champion. End up taking Kambal, I believe. Yeah, I take the Kambal. Unclaimed Territory and Mox Pearl for me. Just go turn 1, Dark Confident. Just draw some cards. Hope to get the land for the Kambal. So on my turn, the Dark Confident triggers, and I end up drawing a Black Lotus and a Unclaimed Territory. I had never hit a Black Lotus with a Dark Confident before, and I can tell you it's fun. I highly recommend it. So I end up playing the Kambal here, and they in response Brainstorm, which just smells of desperation to me, which is great. I love desperation in an opponent. And yeah, Kambal resolves. I play a Thaddeus Lieutenant, so now I have a clock going. But yeah, like the the extra 1 damage just doesn't really matter that much, because now they take 2. And from the Ponder, they take 2 again. From the Preordained, Dark Confident triggers again. And I end up drawing another Dark Confident. I play Noble Hierarch. And yeah, in this case, we just have Xaxes because of the being able to play 2 humans and the Thaddeus Lieutenant and the Noble Hierarch. But on average, like, I think we would have won this game anyway if we had just Dark Confident and Kambal here. Like, we would have hit for 2 less, so... And if we had any other human in that spot, so we would have hit for 2 less, but we might have been more disruptive. So definitely something to look out for. I end up boarding out some more stuff. Preordain for them again. I have a Cavern of Souls and a Kambal. So I kept a 3 lander with a 3 drop in Vintage, and I end up just Once Upon a Timing for a champion, getting a 1 drop. And yeah, just playing it. It's on the Cavern. They gush. So they're definitely looking for cards here. Like, there's no reason to gush otherwise. They Preordain here. They end up playing a Mox Ruby. And yeah, I top deck a Dark Confident like a pro, because I'm just that good at the game. So I keep a hand with 3 lands and 2 3 drops and end up curving out 1, 2, 3, which is kind of nice. It's just pro things, you know. They start to plowshares my Dark Confident. I end up playing a Kambal. It can't be countered because of Cavern of Souls. They try and Force of Will it anyway, so yeah, good for them. That's not happening. Kambal resolves, and they're gonna cry because they just wasted 2 cards and a life. And at this point, I can just beat down. Like, this is basically the same situation as last game, except for the Thaddeus Lieutenant. And I still think I'm just super far ahead. They Cadexian Probe me. Like, you can Cadexian Probe when I have a Kambal out. That's fine. And once again, I get the +1/+1, but yeah, like, it doesn't shave a turn off the clock at all. Like, I don't think the Lords matter very much. So for match number 2... we keep this hand with a Strip Mine Cavern Horizon Cavern. They go Mox Jet into Preordained. What a surprise. People are playing real cantrips in this format. Once Upon a Time hits a Thalia's Lieutenant. I end up just playing Cavern Go. They go Time Walk into nothing. They end up Demonic Tutor in their second turn. Find a Dark Ritual. And then they Doomsday me. Which is search a library and graveyard for 5 cards and exile the rest, put the chosen cards on top. And yeah, so at this point, nothing I do ever matters again. And they are just probably going to kill me next turn. So they Ancestral Recall. Draw 3. And they play a Thassa's Oracle. Like, that card's just stupid in every format as well. Like, Theros has brought so many design mistakes into Magic. It's unreal. Yeah, I board in 3 slots to plowshares. I might be able to mice out a trigger or something. I don't know. I keep this double Once Upon a Time hand on 6 cards. Bottom one of the Once Upon a Time. Find a Cavern of Souls out of the Once Upon a Time. Cavern of Souls is so busted in this format. It's unreal. So we end up playing a Dark Confident. Yeah, Dark Confident coming into play. They Chain of Vaporit, which will return target non-land permanents. And I can sacrifice a land to bounce one of their non-land permanents. But I'm going to decline on that because they don't have any. I play a Mox Pearl. They steal Sabotages, which is counter-target. And then I play an uncounterable Kambal, which I think they would have wanted to Chain of Vapor, but who knows. So they play, just like our first match, they play a Preordain into a Kambal, take 2 damage for it. And play a Time Walk, take 2 damage for it. Yeah, Kambal is insane. Like, this deck should for sure play 4 Kambal. So they Treasure Cruise. They're drawing a ton of cards, but they're not doing anything. So Mystical Tutor, take 2 more. And yeah, they look for a demonic consultation, which is basically Spoils of the Vault, but on steroids. So Mox Sapphire for them, they take 2 more damage. Like, this is just good. So they get to choose a card name, exile the top 6 cards of their library, then reveal cards until they hit the card they named. And they end up naming Tassa's Oracle in the hope to try and mice me out by having not enough cards in their deck to win with the trigger. And they whiff, and they died. So we have a Strip Mine, an Unclaimed Territory, and a Wasteland. So yeah, they Preordain again. Like, everybody's on Preordain in this format. Noble Hierarch happens for me. They play a Ponder. They play a Preordain. Like, I can see a trend in these decks. I can definitely see a trend. So I play a Dark Confident here. And yeah, at this point, I just try and get some more cards going, get some damage going. But that's just not enough pressure. Like, this deck is in this weird spot where you're either not having enough pressure or the +1/+1 just doesn't matter. It's so weird. Yeah, they play a Dig Through Time as well. Just, they are drawing a ton of cards. Like, they're doing all the fun blue stuff. We attack, and this is just 4 of the Dark Confident on its own. And all I can say is, I wish I had drawn a combo. Like, every single game, I'm just like, can I please draw a combo? Can I please draw a combo? I end up trying to choke them out on mana by Strip Mining them and Wastelanding them. Wasteland and Strip Mine. I just try and choke them out on mana. They missed a land drop at some point. But they find a Black Lotus of the Demonic Tutor. So, yeah, that's not happening. They sacrifice the Black Lotus, play Doomsday. I keep up the Noble Hierarch with the Swords to Plowshares for the Thassa's Oracle, by the way, which is the reason I didn't play the Champion of the Parish here. Like, I can try and mice them out. I think that's just my best shot here. And now I just get to +1/+1 again, but I just want to attack with the Dark Confident. Like, I would have been so much happier if that Mayor of Everbrook was like a Meddling Mage or something, which is definitely something that I noticed throughout the entire league. So they Ancestral Recall. They have 1 card in their deck. They play a Black Lotus. What a surprise. They play a Thassa's Oracle. Who would have guessed? And the trigger goes on the stack. And in response, I just Swords to Plowshares it. That should make me safe to survive it. But they play a second one. And what do you know? I have the second Swords to Plowshares as well. So I Swords to Plowshares this one as well. But they got me, because in response to the trigger, they go and Street Raid to clear out the deck. Like, this is insane. This was such a cool game. But yeah, they got the deck empty, Thassa's Oracle, trigger resolves, and that's that. So for match number 3, we have a Black Lotus, a Wasteland, and a Sanctum Prelate, and a Once Upon a Time. So we Once Upon a Time for a Cavern of Souls. Because why not? I play a Black Lotus. Man, casting Black Lotus is so much fun. We play Champion of the Parish as bait. Then we play the Sanctum Prelate. And I have no idea what they're doing, so I'm just putting it on 0. Hoping to catch them with a bunch of Moxen in their hand. And they play Preordain. And nothing else happens. So I think I got it right. I play Dark Confident and attack for 5. Like, this is just great. Like, there's disruption, there's pressure. Nobody cares about +1/+1. Dark Confident triggers, get some cards going, and they end up like casting an Ancestral Recall here, but they're just not doing anything. I start flooding out here pretty badly. Like, I'm drawing a bunch of Once Upon a Time and a bunch of Mox Emerald and land. They have Empyric Tutor, and yeah, they're just looking for something to get them in the game. I end up trying to choke them out on lands again, because they can't cast Moxen, so getting that land seems pretty good. I end up wasting. They end up lightning bolting my Sanctum Prelate and then just conceding anyway, which is fine with me. Like, I can kill that, but I'm dead, but I can kill that. So we sideboard, and yeah, I have a Collector Oof because I thought they had a bunch of Moxen in the first game, so I put them on like Paradoxical Storm. They play a Sprite Dragon. There are a lot of standard cards in Vintage. It's quite unreal, actually. Because Sprite Dragon is like legit good. Like, it's attacked twice already. It triggers off Moxen. I play a Collector Oof. Yeah, I go Mox Jet Collector Oof, which is a thing. Vintage is such a great format. I had so much fun with Vintage. They play an Underworld Breach. And they aren't doing anything with it, but they are getting it into the graveyard to get just more cards into the graveyard can be relevant. I end up attacking with the Collector Oof and playing a combo. You just always want a gem combo here.
I play a Noble Hierarch next turn. They're not attacking anymore because I will easily win that race. I play a Dark Confident as well. They play a Narset, take two Sprite Dragon Growth, which is another standard card. Like, there are Underworld Breach as well. Like, a lot of these cards are just standard legal. Yeah, so we play a Thalia's Lieutenant, our stuff grows, but once again, it just doesn't really matter. Like, I still don't have good attacks here. I end up trying to pressure them, so I play the second Lord effect as well. And I end up attacking with the Collector Oof, like, with the idea of, okay, so they can cast two spells before dying, and it's a really hard call for them to get me dead in that time. But they end up getting there because they repeal. I didn't know they had a repeal. So, yeah, they repeal my combo and then just bolt me after playing a Lightside Down. They have exact CC. Like, this game was super close. The Humans deck is definitely very impressive. And I think, like, with the blue card, with a bunch of blue cards, you can just make it a lot better. I think this deck is very viable, to be honest. So, if you're ever looking to get into Vintage, yeah, I would check this out for sure. Yeah, so we have an Unclaimed Territory onto a Noble. They play a Ponder. Yeah, they play a Mox Sapphire. And yeah, they play a Preordain. Like, this is just fun. Like, turn one Ponder, turn one Preordain. I play a turn two Kamball again. And just every game where you're playing Kamball just feels so much better. And at this point, they kind of make a tell because they Pithing Needle the Wasteland, which tells me that they're choked on mana. But I can't do anything about it. But I would have loved to have more things to do with interacting with that land. Like, if there's a human that just destroys a land, I would actually probably run it. Like, four wasteland, a land destruction human. Oh, they Force of Will, my Thalia here. I was trying to choke them out that way. Just Mayor of Averbrook coming in. And they just end up lightning bolting the Kamball. They go to four. Yeah, Noble Hierarch goes in. Does it? Do I send in the Noble? I might just cast Once Upon a Time here. No, Noble goes in. I just want them dead. And they have one card in hand and they top deck an Underworld Breach. And just as in every other format, Underworld Breach is a really stupid card. So they Demonic Tutor, get Lion's Eye Diamond. They dump a bunch of stuff. And now they're just replaying their hand every time again. And I just fast forwarded it at this point. They're doing Demonic Tutor. They're brain freezing again, just like the first opponent. They're just going off with brain freeze. Yeah, now they can just mill their entire deck. Like, they can play Lion's Eye Diamond. They can replay Back Lotus and just go to town on us that way. So we've lost at this one, which is really stupid. Like, we would have had them dead next turn, I think. Let's see, would we have had them dead? Yeah, if we had drawn, I don't know. No, I don't think we would have had them dead, but we would have been very close. And they just, yeah, they just kind of top decked us here. It happens, you know. It's fine. It just happens. So, yeah, they brain freeze. They mill out their deck just like the other person did. And, yeah, they're just recasting brain freeze, targeting us. And we died. So, moving along for match number four. And match number four is, yeah, we have a good hand. Like, we have a Cavern, a Thalia, but just no fast mana. So we play Horizon Canopy and go. I play the Horizon Canopy first because Wasteland and Strip Mine already. And our opponent just goes Mox Ruby, Mox Pearl, Mox Sapphire, Misha's Factory into Lodestone Golem. And we can't cast spells anymore. So we are done here. Like, we are just actually done. Like, I can't cast spells and they're beating me for 5 a turn. So, yeah, that's game. Like, yeah, welcome to Vintage. Get Vintaged. Yeah, so I bought out a bunch of stuff. Bought in Force of Vigor, Collector Oof. I play a Mox Pearl, I play a Lotus Petal. And I kind of try to do the same thing as they did to me in game 1. Where I just Cavern of Souls on human and then just Thalia them. And just hope to mice them out of lands. And, yeah, so let's see if it's good enough. Thalia comes into play and, yeah, non-creature spells cost 1. So they pay 1 for a Mox Opal. And I attack in for 2. Not very interesting at all. Just attack for 2, attack for 2. They play a Mox Ruby and use that mana to play a 1 mana Stone Core Serpent. So, yeah, another standard card. The amount of standard cards in this format is unreal. But I just end up flooding out, drawing a ton of lands. I decide to mice here and just go for the Mox Opal and the Mox Ruby. Just try and get them all out of mana. They go Wasteland and Sol Ring into Phyrexian Revoker. And at this point, I just have all lands. They have a ton of mana. And yeah, we're basically done. They name Aether Vial of the Phyrexian Revoker, which is something I don't play. I don't think... yeah, the list I got wasn't playing Aether Vial. And I think that's correct. Like, Aether Vudges doesn't do that much. I just keep on following the plan of just trying to get them out of mana. But at this point, they just have another... They were flooding out horribly. So my plan of attack was to mice them out of mana, and they just flooded horribly. And now they're playing a Golos. Another standard card. Yeah, I'm very surprised by the amount of standard cards in Vintage. So yeah, Golos comes into play, and they look for a Tolarian Academy. Which is kind of insane. I had not realized that's a thing, but that's really cool. Yeah, at this point, they have a 3-5. I draw 1-1. We're never winning this game, so I'm going to move along. So the fifth match had some technical difficulties. I tried recording it, but the client crashed and the recording just died. And everything, it was just one of those things where everything I tried to do went wrong. So what I ended up doing was just including the entire replay. This is a replay. And as you can see, the technical difficulties are still not over yet. And they play a Bazaar of Baghdad on turn 1, and which means that Dredge. And I just didn't have a hand that could beat Dredge. So I concede on turn 1, while my turn 0. And then I have a Surgical Extraction, Lotus Petal, and a Karakas. They're waiting on the Mulligan decision. Yeah, so Cavern of Souls comes into play. I end up playing a Champion of the Parish. They've Mulligan to 3. I play Lotus Petal, Mox Jet Champion, and... yeah, I have a Surgical, and I'm just praying it's good enough, and they draw a card and they concede. Like, this match is like, what the hell's going on? And for game number 3, all of a sudden the artwork comes back. Like, I have no idea what's going on, but Magic Online is just failing horribly at this point. I play Wasteland Black Lotus, and I'm just gonna end of turn Containment Priest them, or Containment Priest them in response to doing something. I should have gone for the Once Upon a Time first, by the way. I messed that up. I should have gone Once Upon a Time, then Black Lotus. But don't think it'll really matter. So I end up not playing. And they have a turn 3 Bazaar of Baghdad, which I just immediately wasteland. They have a bad Dredge. They have a Bridge from Below, a Force of Negation, and a Narco Meba, which are also all modern legal cards. And end of turn, I go Once Upon a Time and just Containment Priest. Containment Priest uncounterable, and they concede.
So after playing the games, I do not understand for the life of me why we aren't playing 4 Kamball Council of Allocation. This card won us just so many games on the spot. This card is absolutely insane in this format. Like, what the hell? Why are we not playing 4? With that being said, I didn't like the Mayor of Everbrook and the Thalia's Lieutenant. I don't think +1/+1 is very relevant in this format. Like, I know it won us a game, but we won a lot more games by just locking our opponent out and being like this aggressive, disruptive deck. And yeah, the +1/+1 just didn't really... Like, nobody cares about +1/+1 if your opponent is combo killing you with the Breach, with the Underworld Breach. For the rest, I would love to play blue in this. Just get some Ancestral Recalls in there. Meddling Mage, Lavinia is also something I missed. Something I would definitely like to see in this deck. So I could see cutting like all of the green. Well, all of the green. With that I mean like Mayor of Averbrook and Thalia's Lieutenant. Like, cut these 6 and get some... And maybe the Pelagia. Like, Pelagia we just never cast it, so I don't know. But like, you could cut... I could definitely see cutting these 7. Just adding like 4 Lavinia and 3 of the... What was the other one I just mentioned? Meddling Mage. And like, with all the blue you have in the deck then anyway, just add like 1 Ancestral Recall in there somewhere. I can definitely see going that way. I like Dark Confident as well. I could see playing a third one of those. For the rest, the sideboard, yeah, that would need to change then. You need to Force a Vigor to go if you're cutting a lot of the green cards. Collector Roof was great. Surgical Extraction is fine. Priest is... Can also see playing Containment Priest in the main. Source Plosias is fine. So those are the things I would do different. If you enjoyed the content, please like, comment, subscribe. If you have a deck you want me to play, just let me know. And with that, thank you for watching and have a nice day.